Hello dear friends, today we are going to start with the next topic on isometric projection. So before that, you need to know what is orthographic projection. So till now we were drawing projection of solids. In those topics we were drawing the different views, mainly the front view, top view and the side view. So in order to understand the full detail of a particular solid, you need to draw the three views. So that is the one that is the main limitation of orthographic projection. For example, if you are having a rectangular box like this, so in order to understand the full detail of this box, you need to draw all the three views. That is the top view, the front view and the side view. So if we have the details of all the three views, then you are able to understand what the solid is about. But if you are able to represent a particular 3D object in a single figure, then that will help us to save a lot of time. So for that, we are having a new kind of drawing, a new kind of projection, which we call the isometric projection. So isometric projection is what it has been drawn here. We'll be looking into the details right now. So here you can see that instead of the three views, we are compressing all the three views in a single picture. So you can see over here. So if this is a box, suppose I am naming the surfaces of the box like this. That is, the top face is red, the front face is blue and the left face is black. So if you are able to represent it in this manner, you can see that the front face blue will come here, the top face red will come over here, and the left hand side face which is black will come over here. So I hope you can understand the difference. Instead of drawing all the three views of an orthographic projection, you can draw all the three, you can see all the three faces in a single figure. So that is the advantage of isometric projection over orthographic projection. So how does this isometric projection come? So for that, you need to understand like this. That is, if you keep the solid like this and just elevate it by an angle 35 degree from the bottom like this. So if you are elevating it like this, in this position, you can see that you can see this face, second face and third face. So all the three faces can be seen together. So that is why we are insisting or we are using this kind of projection called isometric projection. So the angle is 35.16 degrees. So it is not of much importance to us, but that is just for your information. But in this particular position, you can see that this side will be making an angle 30 degrees and the left side will be also making an angle 30 degrees. Whereas the third axis will be making 90 degrees. I'll explain that. Before that, let's discuss the orthographic projection. So this is the top view, right? So in the top view, suppose let this be the x-axis in the top view. Let this be the y-axis. So the height, the perpendicular distance, the height, this will be your z-axis. So you know why it is called orthographic, right? Because it is mutually perpendicular, 90 degree. Mutually perpendicular axis x, y and z. So in that way, if you take this as the x axis, this as the y axis and this perpendicular height from the ground as the z axis, so we can draw these three figures, condense it into a single figure. So here, how to draw this is very simple. Just draw a line like this and take one salient point, any one corner. Mostly we take the front left corner, the corner at the front left bottom. So that corner you can take it as the reference, and or you can take that as the origin. You draw a line like this. So that will be your x axis. You draw, so the angle, this over here, the angle, it should be 30 degrees. And left side, you draw a line like this. That will be your y axis, and that too will be making 30 degrees angle. And from here, you draw a line vertically upwards. So this is your z axis. So it's very simple. X, all the x dimensions will be drawn 30 degrees to the right. All the y dimensions will be drawn 30 degrees to the left, and all the z dimensions will be drawn 90 degrees in the isometric projection. And we'll explain in detail when we do this problem, when we do one problem. But one important thing which you need to understand is that when you draw the isometric projection, when you keep the object like this, you can see that the length is getting reduced, minimized. All the lengths, you can see that this length, this length, this length, every length is getting minimized because it is not parallel to any of the planes. So you can see that the length which you see is just an apparent length. And as you raise this by 35 degrees from behind, this x and y, as we have already discussed, it will be making 30 degrees. Whereas if you take all the lengths, you can see that there is a reduction in length. There is a reduction in length, and the reduction is around, is approximately 82%. So when you are doing problems, you need to take the length as 82%. So for that, you need to know how to get the isometric scale. So it's a very simple procedure how to plot the isometric scale. So to plot the isometric scale, the procedure is very simple. First, you draw the true length. Suppose in a particular question is having 60 mm as the length, maximum length, 60 mm maximum length. So you take the true length, 0, of, you take 10 mm, you take 20 mm, 30 mm, 40 mm, 50 mm, and 60 mm. And you can go on. Suppose for in a particular question, you just have 60 mm, then you draw from 0 to 60. And the next procedure is, at 0, you draw a line to the right, making an angle of 15 degrees. This is very important. You should know that at 0, you'll draw a line with an angle 15 degrees. And at the final point, at the point 60, you take an angle of 45 degrees. So I hope you have noted it. On the left side, you make an angle 15 degrees. And on the right side, you take an angle of 45 degrees. So after drawing these two lines, you can complete the triangle. And suppose you have to draw a length of 50. You have to take a length of 50. So normally in orthographic projections, you take the length as 50 degrees and you start drawing the figure. But in isometric, what you have to do is you have to take the isometric scale. So isometric scale, you know that the length is getting reduced. So it will be 82% of this length, which is 50. So it will be 50 into 0.82, which comes to around 4.41. So it will be 0.41. So when you're drawing the figure, you have to take 41 mm. You have to take 41 mm, not 50 mm, but you have to draw the figure using 41 mm. So you can't use the calculator to compute this. For that purpose only, we are having this isometric scale. So how to get this 41 mm? It's very simple. So we have already drawn this triangle. At 0, you took 15 degree. At 60, you took 45 degree. And you completed this triangle. The next procedure is, there is an edge over here. So let's name this A, B, and C. Okay. So next, what you have to do is, there is a side BC, right? So next, you draw a line through 50 parallel to BC, like this. So this line should be drawn parallel to BC. So this length which you have is 50 in the true sense, but in isometric 50 will be length from A to this particular point. So this will be your isometric 50 length. So if you measure this length, this is definitely going to be 41 mm. So this length is going to be 41 mm. So if you want the isometric 30 length, what you have to do is, from this point 30, you draw a line parallel to BC, okay, like this. You draw, or what you can say is, you draw a 45 degree line like this, okay, and 45 degree line like this. It will meet the edge AC at this point. You take this length, not the true length, but from A to this particular point, you take this length. This will be your isometric 30 length. So this is about isometric scale. So mostly the question will be you will be asked to draw the isometric projection. So you can expect two kinds of question. One is to draw the isometric projection, whereas the other one will be to draw the isometric view. So both are the same, but the main difference is going to be the length. So when you are asked to draw isometric projection, you will have to draw using the isometric scale, that is the reduced length. Whereas if you are asked to draw the isometric view, then you can draw using the true length itself, all the edges. So make sure read the question and make sure that it is isometric projection question or it is a view question. Don't interchange. Okay. So let's try to do one problem. And before that, so there are two ways in which you can draw this isometric projection question. One is the box method like this, and the other one is the offset method. Sometimes you will have to use both the methods together. So we'll do some problems and then you'll be able to understand it. So let's discuss the first problem. Okay, so the first problem, it's actually a combination problem. Combination problem means you'll be having one solid and there will be another solid which is placed centrally on the other solid. Okay, so the question here is a hexagonal pyramid of height 50 mm and side 24 mm is resting centrally on top of a square slab. So the solid one which is lying below is the square slab, and the solid which is lying above, or we can name it as solid 2, it is a hexagonal pyramid. Okay, so all the conditions are given. Like for the hexagonal pyramid, its axis is kept vertical and one edge of the base is parallel to VP. So regarding square slab, what they have said is the square slab has dimension of 60 mm and thickness, or the this thickness height is going to be 20 mm, and this is the important part. Draw the isometric projection. Okay, so check for this particular word whether it is isometric view or projection. If they are asked, they have asked you to draw isometric projection, then you have to draw it using the isometric scale, which is the reduced length scale. Okay, so draw the isometric projection of the combination of solids. Okay, and the condition of the square slab is given is that it is resting on HP, with one rectangular face. Okay, this is a square slab. So as you all know, a square slab means you'll be having square top and square face bottom in the bottom, and all the lateral faces, four lateral faces, are rectangles. So what they have said is the rectangular face, one rectangular face is parallel to VP. Okay, so if you check the question here, the highest dimension here is going to be 60. So what we are going to do first is you will draw the isometric scale for 60, or safer side, let's draw it for 70 or 80. Okay, so I'm drawing the isometric scale first. So as we have already discussed earlier, you draw the isometric true length from 0 to 60 or 70. Okay, 0, 10 mm, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 and 70. Now what is the next procedure to draw to get the isometric scale length? At 0, draw 15 degree, a line with 15 degree angle, 15, and at 70 you draw a line with 45 degree angle. So the length which you get here will be, since this is 70, so this length is going to be your isometric 70, which by definition is going to be 70 into 0.82, this length. Okay, so in this question, what are lengths are coming here? We have 50 over here, 24 over here, 60 and 20. Okay, so 60 is needed, so you draw a line through 60. Next you need 50. Next you need 20 is there, so you have to draw a line through 20, and next 24. So between 20 and 30 you take 24. So these are the four lengths is coming in this particular question. Okay, so before drawing the isometric projection, isometric view, first what you have to do is you will have to draw the orthographic views first, because it is necessary and it is required. It is a required procedure that you should draw the orthographic views first. Okay, so let's draw the orthographic view. So first you draw the xy line. It's a square slab, so when you are looking from the top, it is going to be like this. This is a square slab, and the square slab, the dimension is given as, it is a square of 60 mm side, and height is given as 20. Sorry, the 60 which you take here, you shouldn't take true 60, but you have to take isometric 60. Why? Because this question, it's an isometric projection question. So instead of 60, you will have to take iso 60. So which means that you have to draw the isometric, you have to draw the orthographic figure using not the true 60 length, but you have to take isometric 60. So you can measure the isometric 60 length from the scale here, mark that dimension and use that particular length to draw this orthographic view. So this should be isometric 60. So you complete the square using isometric 60, and the condition was that one of the rectangular faces is making it is parallel to VP. So you can see that this particular rectangular face, or this particular rectangular face, you can see that both the rectangular faces are parallel to VP. So solid one, the simple portion of the solid one is over, and the height which you have to take, we already discussed, it is not 20, but you have to take iso 20 as the length, as the height. Okay, now on top of this object, solid one, you are having the solid number 2, that is a hexagonal pyramid. Okay, so that is on top of one object, you are having of one solid, you are having another solid like this. Okay, on top of one solid, you are having another solid like this. So it is placed centrally on top of it. So it's very simple to draw. So on above solid one, you have the solid two placed centrally, such that the axis is going to be the same. Okay, axis is going to be collinear. Okay, so how to draw the solid two? You can draw the diagonals. Either you can draw the diagonals, or you can draw the lines through opposite midpoints. Anyway, you locate the center. Okay, you can draw the diagonals. You locate the center, and based on the center, you have to draw the hexagon. Based on the center, you have to draw the hexagon. So, hexagon, as you all know, the interior angle is going to be 120 degrees. So, keeping this point as the center, you can draw a hexagon like this. So, you can draw these angles like this. Okay. So, the hexagon can be drawn like this. So, the condition what they said is, one of the base edge of the hexagonal pyramid is parallel to VP. So you draw the hexagon. After drawing the top view of the hexagon, you have to draw on the front view of the hexagon. Okay, so the top view is drawn like this, and what is the length which you have to take? So the hexagonal pyramid, question is given that the hexagonal pyramid of height 50 mm and side is 24 mm. Okay, so this length is going to be not 24, but you have to draw using ISO 24 length. Okay, so this is the top view of the solid 2 as well as solid 1. So this is the top view of the combination of solids using the isometric scale length. Now, how to transfer this top view to the front view? You draw the projectors. Okay, you draw the projectors. Draw the projectors like this. Okay, draw the projectors like this, and you draw the projector of the axis. The height of the solid is given as 50 mm, so you draw the axis as 50 mm, and you complete the edges. So the height which you have to take is going to be isometric 50. So this is going to be isometric 60. This is going to be isometric 50. The height of the slab is going to be isometric 20, and the pyramid side is going to be isometric 24. Make sure that the axis is drawn at the center itself. Okay, so the orthographic views has been drawn using the isometric lens. Okay, now we are going to draw the isometric projection. Okay, so how to draw the isometric projection? So before that, you are having the three axis system here. We are following the three axis system here. So this is going to be your x dimension. This is going to be your y dimension. And this point pointing upwards, okay, this is going to be the arrow pointing upwards, is going to be your z dimension, that is the height. So x, y and z is the height. So transferring all these data, isometric drawing. So what you're going to do first is, so we know that there are two solids over here. Solid one is a square slab and solid two is a hexagonal pyramid. Okay, hexagonal pyramid, the sloping edges is drawn dark. Okay, so we need to select a salient reference point first. So mostly what we do is, you will take the front left bottom corner. So this corner is mostly the point which you take as the reference. Okay, so I will take that reference point over here. So let's name that reference point. Okay, that point at the bottom, let's name it as 1, the second corner as 2, the third corner as 3, and the fourth corner as 4. Okay, and let's name the base corners of the hexagon as A, B, C, D, E, and F. and the axis as OP. Okay, so this is going to be F dash, this is A dash, E dash, this is B dash, D dash, and this is your C dash. And taking the corners of the square slab, bottom point is going to be 1 dash comma 4 dash, this point is going to be 2 dash comma 3 dash. So bottom corners are 1 2 3 4. Okay, so I'm going to select the left corner, bottom corner, that is 1. So this is my point 1. So as we have already discussed earlier, in the orthographic projection, this is your x direction, this will be a y direction, and perpendicular to the plane of the paper, it is the z direction. So in isometric, it is going to be like this. So you draw a line, 30 degree line to the right. You have to show this as 30 degrees, it's very important. Next, 30 degree line to the left, show this as 30 degrees. Okay, you can extend these lines to both the directions. So this is your x direction, this is your y direction, and this is going to be your z direction. Okay, that will be 90 degrees. So x will be 30 degrees to the right, y will be 30 degrees to the left, z will be 90 degrees. Okay, 90 degrees. So we are going to transfer this box over here. Okay, we are going to transfer this box over here. So let's go to the orthographic figure. So you are going to draw the base of the square slab, 1 2 3 4. Okay, I am standing right over here at 1. So how will I get the point 2? So we know that in order to travel from 1 to 2, you need to move in the x direction. Okay, so x direction. So what is the length between, what is the distance between 1 and 2? It's isometric scale, isometric 60. So what you can do is, you take this length in compass and you mark it over here. That is the distance from 1 to 2 in the x direction, you have to take it and you can draw it over here in the x direction. You take that length, isometric 60 length, and mark it over here. So this is your point 2. Next, I'm standing at 1 right now, and how will I get my point 4? So from 1 to 4, I need to travel in the y direction. And what is the distance between 1 and 4? That is isometric 60. So over here, you can see that y direction line, the axis line is here. So from 1 to 4, take this length, and in the y direction from 1, you will have to travel up to 4. So this isometric 60, that is 60 into 0.82. You mark it over here. So this will be your point 4. So you got your point 1, 2 and 4. Now how will I get my point 3? In order to get the point 3, we know the location of 3. It is at a length of isometric 60 from 4 and isometric 60 from 2. So from 4, you take that isometric 60 length and draw an arc. Now from 2, you take that isometric 60 length, that is the y direction, you draw an arc like this. So this point is going to be your 3. So this is the base of the square slab. This is going to be the base of the square slab, or you can see this as the lamina. Okay, the bottom lamina. Okay, now so the bottom portion of the slab is over, and how will you transfer the height of the box? What is the height of the box? Isometric 20. So you take that length, and we know that isometric 20 is not in the x, it's not in the y direction, but it is in the z direction, the height. So that isometric 20, you will have to transfer that length in the z direction over here. So where is my z direction? From 1, if you take 1, the z direction is going to be this direction. So you take that isometric 20 and you mark it over here. So this is the point just above 1. Now through 4, you draw a perpendicular upward. Through 2, you draw a perpendicular upward. And through 3, you draw perpendicular upward. So this is your height, isometric 20. Next, from 4 you take that isometric 20 length, from 3 you take the isometric 20 length, and from 2 you take the isometric 20 length. You join all these 4 points. This is going to be the top lamina, the square face of the square slab. So you can say that the isometric drawing of the square slab is over. So how to show the representation, dimension representation, is very easy. This is the x direction, this is the y direction, and this is the z direction. What you do is you extend this line in this direction and this particular edge in this direction, and parallel to x you draw a line like this. So this is how you show the x direction dimension. So this is your isometric 60x. Now how will you show the y direction? You draw lines like this, you extend the edges. So this is going to be, and you draw line parallel like this. So this is your isometric 60 in the y direction. And z direction, how to represent? It's not as you think, it's not drawing like this, but you have to follow this particular edge line. You extend this particular edge line, and you extend this particular edge line, and based on that z, you draw a line parallel like this, like this. So this is how you show the z dimension. Okay, so this length, what is this length? You are taking it as isometric 20. So this is the solid one which has been drawn in the isometric projection. Now next we have to draw the hexagon. Okay, hexagonal pyramid. So where is the hexagonal pyramid lying? We know that it is lying on top of the square slab. So the hexagonal pyramid is lying on top of the square slab. So how to get those points? It's very simple. What you can do is you can draw a box like this. Okay, you can draw a box like this which confines or contains that hexagon. Okay, it's not it's having a shape of a rectangle. Okay, so you draw a box like this, okay, which contains that hexagon, which contains that hexagon. Let's name this as 5 6 7 8. Okay, 5 6 7 8. So how to draw that hexagon over here? It's very simple. 5 6 7 8. Okay, what you can do is you extend this 5 line over here onto the 1 2 line, and you extend this over here. So you get a length over here, right? So you transfer this small length on this line, on the top edge line, not on 1 2, but on the top edge line. You transfer this small length which you have over here. Okay, that is this line over here. You draw a box over here, you extend this to meet the 1 2 line. This distance you mark it over here, and the other distance from the corner 2, you take that small distance. This is going to be symmetric, so that length is going to be same. You take that distance over here. Similarly, the other direction of the box, you extend it onto 1 4, and you extend it onto 1 4. So these lengths you will also get. You take these lengths, okay, you take a compass, you take this length using the compass, and you mark it from here to here. Similarly, you take the length from 1, not from 1, the point above 1, and you take this length and you mark it on the top face. So you'll get all the 4 points. Now what you have to do is through x, line parallel to x, draw a line like this and draw a line like this. And parallel to y, you draw a line like this and you draw a line like this. Okay, so that box which you have got is transferred onto the top face, onto the top lamina. Now how to, so what are the corners of this box? This corner it's 5, this corner is your 6, this one is 7, and this one is 8. So on this 5, 6, 7, 8, you have to plot this hexagon. It's a very simple procedure, okay? This box is 5, 6, 7, 8. The box, you have transferred it over here. Now you just measure distance from 5 to A. From 5 to A, it's in the X direction, okay? So from 5 to A, you take this length in compass and you mark it over here. From 5, you take the measurement of 5A and you mark it over here. So this is going to be your point A. Next, from 6, you take the length from 6 to B and mark it in the reverse direction. You take 6B and you take from 6 to left side. So this is going to be a point B. Next, where is the point C? C is lying in between 6 and 7. So between 6 and 7, you take this length 6C and you mark it over here. So this is your point C. Next, how to locate D, E, F? D and E are on 7 and 8, between 7 and 8. You take the distance 7D and you mark from here, from 7, you get the point D. Next, from 7, you take this length, mark the point E. And finally, the point F. F is on 5, 8. Okay, F is on 5, 8. So take that length 5F and you mark it here, so you'll get the point F. So you can see that all the 6 points of the hexagonal pyramid's base has been transferred. Now only one more point is left, that is the apex. That is the apex. So the axis is O dash P dash. So how will you locate P dash on this rectangular lamina? It's very simple. You join the opposite corners of the base. So this point is going to be the point P. That is the middle point of the axis. The bottom point of the axis. Now, what is this height OP? What is this height OP? The height OP is isometric 50. So from P, you extend this line like this. You take the height as ISO 50. It is not 50. Please make note that height you have to take over here is not the true 50 length, but isometric 50 length. You take that length and you transfer it over here from P in the Z direction. Height is in the Z direction. So from P, you take isometric 50 and you get the point O. So that's it. We have got all the points. So now the next procedure is to complete it. So you start drawing the corners of the base of the hexagon. Okay. So actually, we are looking at the object in this direction, so we need to make sure which all edges are visible in our view. Okay, let's talk about the base, the box. Okay, the box, this front face. Okay, if you are looking from the front, this is going to be visible. Okay, not from the front, you are not actually looking from the front, but you are looking at a particular angle which we have already discussed in the initial slide. Okay, so this face is going to be visible. This face is going to be visible, whereas the other two rectangular face, you can't see it in this view. Now, talking about the hexagonal pyramid, this edge is visible. The bottom edge, AF, is visible. AB is visible. Now, what you do is you draw the sloping edges. I've drawn OE first, OF. Next, I've drawn OA. Next, I've drawn OB. Next, I've drawn OC. After drawing OC only, you'll be able to know that this BC is lying outside. Now, what is the edge which is remaining? DE is remaining and CD is remaining. An axis should be drawn using chain line. Now, is it over? No. The box, the the portion at the back should be completed like this. But we can't extend it beyond this particular line because the solid is being covered by solid 2. Solid 1, the back portion is being covered. This height has to be transferred, which is isometric 50. So this is the isometric projection. This is how you draw an isometric projection of combination of solids. In the next slide, we'll be dealing more problems on isometric, where you'll be discussing cases where you'll be drawing the isometric projections of section of solids, then you will be drawing isometric projection of ellipse, sphere, prism, etc. So that we'll be discussing it in the next slides. Okay. Thank you.